all, welcome to the session of Blender. In today's session, we are going to see how do we apply bevelling modifier. So when we say about bevelling modifier, it gives a kind of slant slope to the edges or a different structure to the object. So object gets modified into a different kind of shape. So today we will see how do we apply bevelling modifiers to convert our object into a different structure using the cube as well as cylinder. So to start off with, I'm going to create cylinder. So I will say Shift A, Mesh, and then create my cylinder. Moment I create cylinder, I will get the properties over here. So I have vertices, 32 vertices over here. Radius is 1 meter. Now cap fill type. Now when I say about this, I will show you the triangular kind of structure which gets created. So here I will go to first edit mode. So in edit mode, if you see on top, you get this triangular structure. This is called as filling over here. So let's try to see what operations can I perform using our cylinder. So now in this cylinder, first I will say Control R, so I get a ring structure. Now where do I want to fit the ring structure? So now I want to fit exactly at the center. So I've selected this. Now I will say scale. So when I say S and scale, can you see what is happening to my object? I've added a circular structure and then I'm trying to give it a shape. So now this is how I've done it using the operation. So now let me add one more ring. So I will add a ring over here. So again I will say Control R. I will just left click, so it comes on my circular structure like this. So I select again, I'll say S scale. I can scale it like this. So here this is how I'm trying to scale and give some kind of shape to my object. Let me try beveling. So I will say Control B. So when I say Control B, I've got a beveling to my object. So my object has been transformed to something like this. Let me add one more ring over the top. So when I add one more ring over here, I will say Control R. I will just left click so it comes on top. I will just say here, I will say scale. I want to scale it outside. So I will say scale it like this. Now since my vertices is selected already, I will say Control B. So this is how the shape I am getting right now. If I just go to object mode, this is the shape which is created just by working with the ring structure and working with my beveling over here. So for beveling, normally we work with Control B is the option. Other properties we will see in the other object on cube. So now suppose if I want to bevel and give a smooth structure to every shape over here, if you see there are all pointed edges. So when I want to give a proper shape, I will go to tab mode again. I will say Shift Alt and then select all my rings and then press Control B. Can you see I'm getting a kind of structure like this? I can have more smooth texture, or I can have a smooth texture, how much ever you want to make this smoothness. So I've shifted like this, we'll just make it to this much. Okay. So now let me go and see. So you can see that my texture has become smooth working with my beveling. So this is one operation of beveling where I can work with modifying my object in whichever texture I want. Now let us come to cube. Now let's add some texture to cube. So for adding some texture to cube, to give it a kind of smooth thing, first let me add a color to it. So I will select this, select nodes and then go for color. I will give some kind of color, then I will go to modifier. Since I want it to have smooth edges, I'm going to add my beveling modifier. So I will select bevel. So moment if you see, moment I selected bevel, I'm getting a texture like this with a kind of a slant surfaces at the every edges of my object. So if I want to make it more smooth, I will increase the offset value. So now offset value is 0.1. So this is the amount of beveling I want to do, how much slant I want to make. So as I increase the value, you can see the texture how it is coming up. So if I want to broaden the surfaces, I can work with my offset. So let me just take it this much. So it initially it was 0.1, I made it to 0.35. Now let's come to segment. Now segment is something which you tell me how much round shape do you want at the edges. So if you see over here, on my object, it's not round, it's a kind of triangular structure. So let's increase the segment and see how much value am I getting. I'll go slow. See, now if you can see, the object is getting modified. The numinal, it's looking like a kind of a smooth cube over here. Now what does profiling does? Profile will help me whether I want this smoothness to be inside the object or protruding outside. So 0.5 is a standard value which is there. If I decrease this value, you can see that it's changing its shape. So if I just make it less and see. So here the shape is completely getting changes of my B value because it is protruding inside. So when I want it to extrude out outside, I will just increase the value of my profiling. So it looks like a rounded structure. So I'll make it to 0.5, which was there as by default. Now material is to add color. So when I want, I can go to material and add materials over here by clicking on the plus sign over here. When I add materials, these materials I can call it directly in my modifier also. So that is about adding color to the material. Once this is done, we can also have customized shapes to our objects. Now since we are applying beveling on the edges, if I want to have some kind of different shapes, I can come to my custom profile. So moment I select custom profile, I can have different types of custom profiles over here. So let me select support loops. So moment I do support loops, you can see that over here there are structure has changed. Because this structure is this point, this curve which is there. So if I want to have a different structure, you will see the similarly, the object also has a different structure. So you can see this curve over here. This curve is nothing but this curve which I have got. And if I take this curve also inside like this, the moment I modify my object similarly, the moment I modify the point similarly, my object also gets modified over here like this. So this is how you can create a custom profile. Suppose you want a different kind of shape and structure to the object, you can do that by using the custom profile. I'll just deselect that. So this is about the beveling. So I have applied offset value 0.35 to give a shape like this. My profile is 0.5 because I'm extruding it outside. Then segment value is 7. I can decrease and increase segment value depending on how much smooth shape do I want on my edges over here. Material, if I want to add color, I can add material to it. Now here also I have something called as clamp overlap. Now clamp overlap is used to avoid multiple overlaps of the segments which are there. If I zoom, we can see that there are lots of segments which are there over here. Since the segment should not overlap and become clumsy, I work on the clamp overlap so that the value doesn't increase more than the expected. So at one point, if I keep on increasing the value, see moment I increase offset, as the value is increasing, there is no further shape which is changing. For a reason, because clamp overlap is selected. So clamp overlaps make sure that it does not have too much overlapping of the object, so the object becomes much more clumsy. So when I decrease the value, my object becomes like this. When I increase the value of offset, it becomes like a spherical shape. So this is how is the working of your offset value. So this is with the beveling modifier, which is there with selecting the modifier. Or I can have shape something like this when I work with my beveling by selecting Ctrl B. So when I say apply, it gets applied to my object like this. Thank you.